Hey, Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Welcome to my Christmas room.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
I just uploaded a video on the Canon M5 mirrorless camera. It's a small version of their 80D system, because you got the 80D on the Canon side, which is a very nice camera, no 4K, but it's a very nice camera. Now, they took the sensor from the 80D and the dual pixel focus, which is superb, okay? And they put it in the 80D, of course. They also put it in the 77D. They also put it in the T7i. They also put it in the M6, and they also put it in the M5. So if they ever tell you can't have a choice of what toppings you want on your ice cream, come on. Canon has given us 5 cameras with the same sensor and dual pixel focus. Remarkable, huh? All right, so I am recording with the GH5 right now, and I can see myself here. I'll fix my hair, make sure I look good. That's one of the advantages of using one of these things. Now, I need a haircut, you know. Time for a haircut. So this has Wi-Fi also. However, you cannot stop or start the recording of a movie on here through the Wi-Fi. But you can stop and start or take a picture with a regular stills image. Like you can shoot the shutter and it'll take a picture. Now in the Panasonic and the Canon 80D, you can stop and start your video. So if you're a one-man show, that becomes really, really important. All right, now the reason for this video is this camera's ready to go back, okay? It's a demo unit. They allow me to use it, and then I send it back. However, with the video that I put up, I got a lot of questions, which surprised me, and the questions were, should I pick the M5 or the M6? And I've been answering the M6. Let's keep it clear. I've been answering the M6. However, I have done a little bit of a mental change. And the reason is, the difference between the M5 and the M6, so you know, they're basically the same camera. But this one has the hump on top, so it's got a viewfinder built in. The M6, there is no viewfinder built in. You only look at the LCD screen on the back. They do have an accessory where you can put an EV onto the hot shoe. So that's another thing that you have to put on. So the advantage that for one camera over the other comes down to something that's really, really simple. It's not rocket science. The M5 tilts the screen downward. Now, the disadvantage of that is you lose your tripod hole for if you wanted to mount the camera on a tripod, so on and so forth. The M6 does the same thing, but instead of putting the LCD so it flips downward, they make it so the LCD flips upward. So that's the difference between the two cameras. So which one is more important? So if you want to put, let's say, an external microphone on the M6, which this is the M5, you would have to rig the camera in a way where you'd have to put a tripod bar or something on the bottom and put a microphone to the side. So I have a Rode microphone here. This is a stereo Rode Pro. It would have to go here. You'd have to buy a piece to go on here. If you did put it here on the M6, you could no longer lift the LCD up. However, it's got a little protection guard here. On the M5, you can put it here. And it can go like this. And the demo unit that I have gave me the bigger lens, which is the 18-150. It is really, really darn fun. F-U-N-N fun. All right. So now what I can do is I could plug the external mic here into the external mic plug, because both cameras have a plug for the external mic. Surprise, okay? So now what I could do is I could take the LCD and put it out, and this is what I wind up with. Now, if I take the camera and I grab it like this, turn it upside down, I now have my LCD screen up on top. See that? And the microphone's on the bottom. So I get my professional sound. So, and with the larger lens, I can use it as something to hold with. So I could just hold it like this. I could see myself up here. The mic is down here. So this is like an awesome vlogging camera. And if you want to put it down, you just flip your hand like this and you can set it down. Did you see how I did that little quick move? And then you can open it up again. So where I used to say the M6, darn it, this is a better thing. So you say, well, Peter, what happens when you have an upside down picture? Well, everybody has to hang upside down to see the pic. No, you don't. There's a little button in your computer on the program that says flip vertical, and you just flip it and it's done. So it's instead of being upside down, it turns right side up. So you still lose the tripod screw with the M5 on doing this. However, you can put it on a tripod. And like I said, you can use the Wi-Fi and let it be on the phone. So if you're sitting at home and you're going to vlog and go, hey, YouTube world, what's up today? You can still see what you're doing here, but you will have to go over to the camera, start it up, and run back here. And that's okay, because you could still use this, and you could just even tap on the screen if you wanted to, but because it's got dual pixel focus, it'll lock on a face if you've got it set to face detection. So where I used to say, get the M6, now I've changed my mind, and I'm saying get the M5, because now if I was vlogging or using the camera, I could use it normally, no problem. The mic is on it, I could see the camera, what it's shooting on the LCD screen, I get full use of this. Even if I put it on a tripod, the tripod screws on the bottom, everything is fine. Same thing with the M6. I'd be able to, you know, do the same thing, put the mic on here. Now, the problem comes in when you want to take the camera off the tripod and you want to go vlogging. You want to bring this into the real world. So what happens is, a lot of people want to up their quality on the sound. They don't want the microphones from the camera. And to be honest, I did try it. And the difference is very, very large between the microphones on the camera and a Rode mic, even just a decent one. It's really a difference of night and day. So what you do is you get the M5 and you grab, you flip the LCD screen down like this. You grab the camera like this. And you're vlogging. It's got like a built-in handle, especially if you get the large lens. Because if you get the one with the smaller lens, you won't have as much to grab. And let's say you want to turn it around, you could turn it around and you could see what's going on here, just like that. And then you could flip it back around, flip it back up, and you're going. So let's say you want to a vlog and you're going like, I'm going to my nephew's birthday party. So here we are at my nephew's birthday party. Everything is going good. And let me show you what it looks like. He's going to blow out the candles. So you flip it over, pull the LCD up like that, and you just continue naturally. So I was saying the M6, honestly, I'm very surprised even at myself, even without the haircut yet. I'm switching to the M5 as the recommended camera. Sorry, that's the way it is. The big negative on these cameras, no 4K, and the quality from 1080 is not terrific, but not bad. All right. The video before this actually has a sample of what the video looks like from this camera. But I've now changed my recommendation from the M6 to the M5. Now, the next camera I'm going to get in to play with is the 77D and the T7i. Now, the T7i is the lowest price point at getting dual pixel focus and a plug-in for your mic, external plug-in for your mic, and a fully articulating screen. It comes out to the side instead of up or down. It would have solved all these problems of making multiple cameras if they just, instead of putting the hinge on the top or the bottom, they just put the hinge on the side and just let it go out and in. Who is coming up with these things? I don't understand it. I need to go to those meetings. So the next time when I say I can't come to the meeting, I'm just going to have to go and tell them. I'll have to set them straight for all of us. All right, so I now recommend the M5 over the M6 because I can flip the screen down like that, which is what you're seeing there, but I can flip it around. I got the lens as a handle, and I am blogging. Happy vlogger. All right, that's it. Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. If you got any questions on this, this is going back right like tomorrow. So ask it now. All right, Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Catch you later. Bye-bye.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching. Description of all equipment used in this video, plus any notes Peter took while filming, are always placed in the description box, show more box, or down arrow thingy next to the title on mobile apps. Duly noted.